Hello guys, in this video we will see how to create Red Hat Linux virtual machines in Azure. Once we log into the Azure portal, we have these services loaded. If you want to see all the services, click on this More Services. If you want to see all services, just click on All Services. See, these are all the services. If you want to filter, just type here. Again, go to Azure portal homepage. Then here search for virtual machines or click on this virtual machines icon. It is best practice to filter here. Virtual machines. Just click on it. See, at present I don't have any virtual machine in my Azure cloud. Click on create and select virtual machine to create a virtual machine in Azure cloud. First we have to select the subscription type. Then resource group, here I am giving resource group as Azure VMs. Then click on OK. Then we have to provide virtual machine name. Open VM. And I am going to install. See, we have this many operating systems. Linux or Linux, Ubuntu 20, SUSE, Red Hat, Oracle, Debian, CentOS, and Windows. I am going to install Red Hat Linux 8.2. Select it and provide the name RHEL. It should be meaningful and unique. And region is East US. Availability options, no restriction, no infrastructure redundancy required. And security type standard. Here I am going to create Red Hat Linux Enterprise Linux. Size is 8 gigabytes memory, but cost for month is 5000 INR. See all the sizes. I want to reduce the memory size. I am in pre-trial. I am selecting less memory. I am going with general purpose, 2 CPUs and 4 gigabytes RAM, and select it. Wait, it is loading the price. Per month. See, per month its cost is 2187 INR. Depends upon the type of currency you given at the time of creating the subscription. And here we have two authentications. One is SSH key, public key, and the other one is password. At present I am going with password. Here provide the username. I am giving username Azure VM user 1. Provide the password for this Azure VM user 1. Confirm the same password. Then public inbound ports. If you want to allow none, then select none. If you want to allow selected ports, then select this radio button. Select list of the available ports. Now go to top. See, here we have disks. Disk type I am selecting as standard SSHD, and encryption type default. I am going with the default one. Then click on this attach an existing disk. If you don't have a disk, then click on create and attach a new disk. I am selecting 32 gigabytes. Now encryption type I am going with the default one. Enable shared disk, 2 or 3 available. I am going with default option, that is 2. Then click on OK. See, we have attached the premium SSD disk. This is the name of the disk. Okay. Now click on networking. This is the virtual network type. If you want to create, click on this create and give the name. This is the subnet and this is the public IP. We will see this while connecting to the RHEL. Management. These are the different options. Auto shutdown. If you want to enable auto shutdown, then we have to provide the time. By what time it has to shut down. I am not giving this option. The notification will be sent to my email. Advanced options. These are the options. Select any one of them. Tags. If you want to provide tags, then provide the tags. Then click on review and create. Notice here. It is going to charge per hour 2 rupees and 99 paisa. It is almost 3 rupees per hour. And these are the settings. These are the basic settings of the my virtual machine. Subscription, resource group, virtual machine name, region and availability options. Then security, that is standard. Image, that is operating system type. Then size of the, and then memory size. Then password, authentication type is password. Username is Azure VM user 1. Okay. And these are the disk details. These are the networking details. This is the management details. And here advanced option. Once you satisfy with this price and options, then click on create. It is initializing deployment. See notification, it is submitting deployment. Now it has been changed to deployment in progress. Deployment is success. Now click on go to resource, or if you want to create another VM, just click on this another VM. Now go to resource. Notice here in the left side overview tab, see resource group is Azure VMs and operating system is Linux Red Hat. Size is 2 CPUs, 4 gigabytes. And public IP is this one. Virtual network subnet is this one. Okay. Now we are going to connect to this VM from the PuTTY. We are going to connect via SSH with client. See here. Open client of your choice as PuTTY or other clients. Now open PuTTY. I have opened PuTTY. Then just paste. Then just copy this public IP. And port number is 22. Then click on open. Select yes. Here we have to provide username. If you are unable to find username, then click on disconnect. See here, this is the username, that is Azure VM user 1. Azure VM user 1. Then provide the password for this user we have given at the time of VM creation. See, we have successfully connected to my Azure VM, that is Red Hat Linux Enterprise Linux. Clear screen by typing Ctrl L. Who am I? See, I am connected with user Azure VM user 1. Let's verify the version. More OS / etc / OS - release. See, its name is Red Hat Linux Enterprise and version is 8.2. So we have successfully created Azure VM for Red Hat Linux Enterprise. For more Azure and Linux videos, please subscribe my channel. Thank you.